Okay. I see so many of you have joined in. Hey, Dashita. Hi, Gurleen. Hi, Harshika. Hi, Rasika. Hey, Akshaj. How is everyone doing? Wow. So I see so many of you have joined in, and we are still expecting more people to join in. So how about, you know, I have a wonderful introductory video about 90th percentile. We will have a look at it. In the meantime, everyone is joining in. Okay. So let me just play it for you guys. And here we go.
Hello, and welcome to 98th Percentile. We're an online education company that offers live math and English courses for K-12 students to get them a grade ahead in 6 months or less. We also focus on building young entrepreneurs through our live coding and public speaking programs. Our rockstar teachers focus on small classroom sizes with only up to 4 students per classroom. This means that your students receive the benefit of fun and engagement with their peers while also receiving the benefit of personalized attention from their educators. We do all of this at an unbeatable price that delivers 4 times the value of any other similar program out there today. At 98th Percentile, we've already helped accelerate over 1,000 students' academic career and have received prestigious awards from all across the world.
Wow, wonderful. So I see many of you have joined in. Hey, everyone. Hi, Ashita. Hi, everyone. Hi, Dashita. Hi, Gurleen. Hi, Rashika. I hope everyone is doing fine. So let me take this opportunity to, you know, welcome all the wonderful designers and storytellers to the biggest comic strip contest of the year, and that is 98th Percentile Comics. Hey, everyone. So, yes, we are again, you know, like we are back. And before I begin, just a friendly reminder, we would be recording this session for quality and marketing purposes. And let me tell you a secret. We would be uploading small snippets of this video on our social media handles. So guys, you want to keep your smiling faces on, right? You want to look good for the Facebook and Instagram. Wonderful. So now a quick recap. I was, you know, kind of amazed and like, I felt wonderful hearing all the, you know, amazing concepts and stories that you people had in mind, especially Ishita, Dashita, all of yours, Aryan, all of you had wonderful stories. I was going through all of them in Ms. Zahira's class. And in the first class, we learned, how do you take certain characters and, you know, develop stories around them? What are the key elements of storytelling? And how do you go about it, right? How do you frame a plot line out of it? So now, so far, what is the progress? We have our key characters, we have a storyboard. Now we need to understand how would we be, you know, converting that into a design. How would we designing that into a comic strip? And that is why we have gathered here once again for the second masterclass, that is how to design a comic strip. Now, as you know, Ms. Zahira said that it would be Ms. Sanskriti who would be teaching you how to do that. And that definitely is not me. So let's welcome Ms. Sanskriti. She would be the design instructor for today's class. She'd be teaching you guys how can you, you know, actually transition the storyboard that you have prepared into a wonderful, beautiful comic strip. So let me just introduce Ms. Sanskriti here. Hi, Ms. Sanskriti. The kids are all yours now.
Hello, everyone.
You guys would be having a lot of fun.
Right. Hey, okay. So hello everyone, I hope you all are doing just great. I am Sanskriti and I will be your design instructor for today. I want to welcome all of you to the biggest online comics event. So are you guys excited? Show me some virtual thumbs up and excited faces. Come on, all right, great. So like Path has said that, you know, we'll be learning how to, you know, through storyboarding process, how will we create our own story with our own story with the basic tools, basic elements, basic concept, and make it to a beautiful design. So let's get started. The first thing that you have to do is go to your browser and type Canva, C-A-N-V-A, and hit enter. Once you do that, you will see the first link under www.canva.com, click that link. and it will lead you to multiple templates. You will be able to see the homepage of Canva. So as you can see, Canva is a fun online software where you can design your presentations, your illustrations, your school projects. So you can try this software whenever you have a free time. So how do we get started? The first thing that we have to do is go to our search bar on the top and type comic and hit enter. Once you do that, you will see multiple colorful templates with different elements. As you can see, doesn't they look good? They're beautiful. They're beautiful colors, beautiful alignments, beautiful characters. So we are going to learn how we can achieve that using the elements within Canva. So in our last session, we learned a new story about Wonder Woman. Isn't she just great? Do you see her, that, you know, the colors, the way she, you know, wears her cape, she takes her, you know, whip. Okay, I have a question for you guys. Tell me, what is the name of the whip that she carries with her? What is the actual name of that whip? What is the weapon she uses? Can someone tell me? Please type your answers on the chat box so that I can see the answers. Come on, guys. I'm waiting for some answers. Come on. Right? Okay. Akshaj has answered. Come on, people, more answers. What do you call it? All right. So I'm going to tell you the right answer. The right answer is, it's called Lasso of Truth. The Lasso of Truth. So she takes that Lasso of Truth and she, you know, she catches all the robbers, thieves, and bad people. So now, what we are going to do here is, we are going to see that how we can achieve using simple elements, using very less elements, and create our own story. So Canva provides us like multiple thousands of elements that we can use, and we can create our own storyboard according to our own imagination. So how we are going to achieve it? Let's get started. As you can see that I have already, aligned six boxes here. That was according to the story that we had in mind. But if you want to add more boxes, all you have to do is you have to shrink the size of each box and fit it with a proper alignment and equal spacing, and you can add one more box. So the maximum boxes that you can have in one page can be 9, but I would suggest you to keep it within 6 to 9 so that, you know, it looks much more cleaner. It is not very congested. And at the same time, it looks much, much easy to read, easy to understand. So that's why we have taken a story which sums up within 6 boxes. So over here, as you can also see that we have added our captions. So I'm zooming in so that you guys can see it. So as you can see, in our last class, we had 5 stages, in which first stage we introduce our character. Second stage, we show a storyline that, you know, from one character to another character. Then we have a climax scene. Then we have the major climax scene where we, you know, actually, you know, we have a confrontation of the, you know, the good character, the bad character. And then we have the moral of the story. Over here, we have somewhat done the same. We have added the captions according to our story first itself, so that we will have an idea of how many characters do we need, what all elements do we need to design our storyboard. So in our first frame, our caption says, Wonder Woman has the day off. She's all relaxed and roaming around him in her living room with the cat. So she has a cat, that is one character. Wonder Woman is the second character. Third is the elements around. So let's say she says living room. You can add any element around that is, you know, suits your area of the story. So let's start one by one. So first I need is a background. I need a background which I've already chosen. That is, a peach color with a basic shape. You can always use, you can use circles, you can use, rectangles, squares, according to your requirement. So I have chosen here a square with a basic color. Now I need to add my elements of the living room. So what do I do? How do I get started? So, sometimes there's a lot of confusion. So I'm going to go to the first tool here on the left-hand side, and I can search any template. I can just type, living room, so that it shows me stories which probably have a living room. If you don't find something in your searches, you can always cross it and you can just look around for the templates that you want to use to just get started. So let's see that I will go with this template. I will choose a template from here, add as a new page, and it will open another artboard where I can see the template that I've chosen. Over here, I see a beautiful living room, but I don't need these characters. I already have, my characters in my mind and they don't suit in them. So I click each of them by shift and I click multiple times to the objects that I don't want, to the elements that I don't want, and delete them. Similarly, I don't want this text, neither I want this time, nor the boxes. So I'm going to delete everything. I also have my own background, so I'm going to delete this background. I will select all of these. Control-C, Command-C, copy it, go to my design, go to my artboard, select the frame that I want to paste in, and I will paste it. So as you can see that without, going around a lot and, finding elements one by one, I have found my elements all together as a set in our template. I copied from there and pasted it. All right. So now you see that I've already added my text box also. I can drag it here so that it doesn't clash with my, setup. I will first group these projects so that, they remain in a similar position. So what for grouping, there's an option on the top, group. I will click that. And now all these elements are grouped together. Okay. I will remove this text box, bring my elements back to its place. I will align it properly so that it doesn't go outside the box or it leaves any space inside the box. Right. And then I will match the background to the frame again. Okay. So now you can see that I have already added my dialogues. So you can add your dialogues beforehand itself so that it gives you a clarity that how do you want to continue with your story. So once you have your set caption and dialogues ready with a perfect font, you can keep the text box on the frame. And then while you place your characters, your elements, you can put them back. So please try to choose fonts which are easy to read, which has enough space between each other, space between the lines, and are not very cramped or very small that it makes hard for people to read or understand the story. So now I'm going to take this textbook back to my first frame. Oh my God. Now you see that this is going behind my window. But I want this to be on the top so that people can read. So how do I do that? I click right and place it here over the elements, and I will get an option to bring it in front. Or if not, if it says send to back, you just send to back. Then you send the background to back, the floor to back. So what does these four tools do? So send to backward puts your element one step backward. Send to back put your elements two right at the back. Bring forward brings your element one step forward. and bring to front brings your element right at the front. So just giving you an example that let's say this is the textbook which I brought right into the front, and this is the window which is behind this textbook, but front of the background. So you can always try these tools and you will understand that how they work. So once you are making it, this will solve your problem of front and back. All right. So now we have our living room ready. Now, what do we need? Let's say I don't like this, the color of the window or the curtains. So I ungroup the element first. Now I have each element separated. Now I go to my window. On the top, I have a color panel. I have multiple colors over there. I click to the color that I want to be removed. As you can see, there are some 50 colors right there. So what do? I can choose the colors from here itself. I can choose the color from here itself, or I can just, go to this plus icon and move my mouse here and there and choose the color that I want. So let's say I want to change the color to pink instead of blue. So similarly, for each element that you use, you can change the colors. You can change the color of anything in Canva if the element is from Canva, right? Now, what is the second thing that I need? The second thing that I need is my character, my main character, who is Wonder Woman. So what I have to do is I have to go to uploads. And as you can see that I have already selected my characters beforehand to save some time. I have already, collected it from Canva and downloaded few elements from outside. So sometimes you want to make a story about a Superman or a superhero or anything that is not available within Canva templates. You can always go to Google, download that element as an image and upload it right here on images. So it asks you upload media. Once you click on that, it will ask you to open the folder that you have your element saved. And then you can choose it and it will directly show over here. So I have already got everything that I need here so that, I can save some time beforehand, and you can do the same thing. So once you are decided with your character, first, you can keep them aside so that you can easily use them and save time in designing the storyboard. So now, let's say that I want this posture of my character to be here. So I drag her and I shrink the size and align it properly to my frame where I need her to be. So I have added my character here, right? Now, my second character is the cat. How do I add that? You don't see a cat here. On the left-hand side, there's a fourth tool called Elements. This is a major, major important tool. This is a tool that will help you to find any possible element that you need to design your story. So what you have to do is, you have to go to the search bar on the top and type cat and hit enter. So once you do that, you see that you have multiple options of cats. You have beautiful cats, beautiful colors of cats, and you have paws, you have faces. So I need a cat that is right here next to my Superwoman. So what do? I select that cat that I want. I again drag her to the frame that I'm working on, align her, shrink her to the size that I need, the required size, and on the top, I again get color options. If I want to change the color of the cat, I select that color, change the color of the cat according to my requirement. So for every time you choose a portion, you have four portions of colors. That means there are four colors involved in one cat, and you can go to each color and you can change them. So now I have my cat ready. I have my Wonder Woman ready. I have my living room ready. I already added the dialogue beforehand where she says that finally a day off, I will relax and spend my whole day with my cat Betty. I think she is hungry, and so am I. So she is mentioning that she is hungry. So let's see that, you know, if we can add some element to show that what she wants to eat. So children, I have a question for you. I want to know, what is your all-time go food that, you know, you want when you're hungry or you want to snack? Which food do you go for? Is it a pizza? Is it a burger? Is it like a sandwich? Are you know, chips or what whatsoever? Tell me, and you know, I want to know the answers. Please type your answers on the chat so that I can see and we can use that element. Okay, I see answers coming. Okay. Chips, okay. Okay, bananas. Oh, healthy. Okay, what else? Come on, guys. I want everyone to give me one snack. Come on. Type your answers. Type your answers fast, fast, fast. Then I will tell you. Okay. Lava cake. Oh, cookies. Mmm, yummy. All right. Do you know what is the favorite food of Superwoman? She loves burgers. And so do I. I love burgers so much. They are delicious. They are creamy. They are like, yeah, they're hot, spicy burgers. I love burgers. And so do Wonder Woman. So we are going to go with burgers here. So now, without writing burgers, how do I depict that, you know, what does Wonder Woman want? So what do I do is, I go to my elements, type cloud bubble. You can also type speech bubble. I'm typing cloud bubble because, you know, it looks like a cloud. So anytime you want to search any element, you can always use different keywords. You can always use synonyms. So over here, I drag it, place it, align it properly, change the color of the cloud. I don't want a black cloud. I want a white one. I put it right next to Wonder Woman. And then what do I do is, I go to elements again and type burgers. Choose the burger that, you know, suits your illustration type. Choose your color scheme and place it. So let's say this one is a good burger that I can use for my theme. So I click on it and I'm going to shrink it and put it inside my cloud bubble. Place it properly. Okay. So now you can see that without even saying that she wants to eat a burger, she's thinking about a burger. So that is what we call to add details to the frame, to your story. So you don't have to necessarily say that, you know, she wants a burger. You can just put a picture of it and you can tell people that this is what she wants. So now, similarly, someone type bananas, you can go on your search bar and type banana, hit enter, and you see banana, right? Similarly, for cookies, you can type cookie and hit enter. You see how many beautiful elements are there and so many with so many options? Don't forget to choose only free options. If you go for the paid ones, like you see over here, it shows pro, then it won't let you save your design. At the end of saving the design, if you use any pro element in your whole storyboard, it will ask for a payment. But you need to remember that all the elements that you use over here are the free ones. Always go for the free elements. Okay, with this, we have completed our first frame. So I want everyone to clap and, you know, show me thumbs up that you are getting and you're understanding the class. Come on, guys, I need to see some reactions. Come on, fast, fast, fast. Show me some reactions. All right, great, great, great. So now we have to start with our second frame, second panel. So someone can tell me that, you know, how does Wonder Woman travel from one place to another? How does she go from one place to another? Does she walk? Does she take a car? She takes a bus? Or how does she go from one place to another? Can I get some answers? Okay, yes, 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 I'm getting some answers. Please type, okay. She flies, flies, flies. Yes, guys, correct. She flies. She flies from one place to another. Now, if she has to go to a cafe or a restaurant, how does she go? She will fly. So in the second frame, I'm going to start with adding my background, adding my first element, that is a sky. I will type sky. You can also type clouds, and you can find the best element that you want, which suits your illustration and story type. So let's say I'm going to go with this. It's a beautiful, beautiful sky with beautiful curly clouds. And I think that this is good to go. So what do I do next? Now my text box, which is already there, it's behind. So I right click it and send this element to one step backward. See, so easy. It just went backward and let the text box come in front. So I will adjust the frame properly. So now you see that, you know, I have more space here and less space here. So how do I adjust that? I double click this on the corner. I get four points where I can, you know, stretch it, or, you know, I can reduce the size, reduce the width. I'm fixing it according to my frame line. Little bit more. Right. So now I have equal spacing on both the sides. Similarly, you can do for all the elements that you get here, that you get from elements tool. You can always adjust the sizes. You can always change the colors. Isn't that just great? It makes your work so much easier. So now over here, I'm again going to uploads, and I'll choose a character that where she's flying. All right. So I'm placing it here. But it looks like instead of going to a restaurant, she's coming back home. I don't want that. So what do? I go to flip on the top. Once you click on an element, you will get an option of flip. I click that and flip it horizontally. Right. So now she's going to a cafe. I think she forgot, you know, the route, and she was going in a wrong direction. But now she's going to the right direction. She's going to her restaurant or cafe to have a great, delicious burger. Over here, we have already added a dialogue saying that where Wonder Woman says that, I have a craving for a burger. Let me just get one. I should take my whip just in case. So she wants to go. She wants to enjoy her free day. But she's like, no, you know what? What if I find some bad guys? So I should just, you know, take my lasso of truth just in case. So with this, as you can see, I've added only two elements here to make the story cleaner, simpler. And, you know, by adding only 2-3 elements, I could complete my whole, frame, whole panel. You can also add, you know, a little sun behind. You can add words if you want, or you can also show a plane, you know, going from here. So that all depends on your creativity. I want to see that what all elements you guys use and make your story better and add little details to make it much more interesting. Now, with this, we have completed our second panel. Now we are going to start with our third panel. So over here, as you can see, we have a caption written. While she's quietly eating her food at the back of the restaurant, she notices the villain, Steely Burgers. Oh my God. So now we have a villain here. So this panel has to be very interesting. So Steely Burgers is robbing the restaurant of cash and burgers. So he's running away with cash and burgers, and Wonder Woman saw that. So in this frame, what all we need to add? We'll count. So first thing is we need to add Wonder Woman. Second thing we need to add is our villain Steely Burgers. Then we need to add the restaurant or the cafe. And we need to add our element, that is burger, with the text box of dialogue. So now what we do is we again go to our elements, type cafe. You can always use different synonyms. And you choose the cafe that you want. I will properly align it. again it hit my textbook. So what do I do is I send it one step backward. That is send backward. Now I got my textbook in front. Now, do you see that there's no difference between the background and the floor? So let's create a floor of our own. Over here, I go to rectangle. Hit enter. Choose a rectangle that I want. Put it at the bottom of the panel. Now it's behind, it's on the top of my cafe and my text box. So I two times select send backward. I have to select it one more time, send backward, because there were two elements ahead. So now this is a very dark color. I want the color to be reduced. So either I choose a light color, or what do I do is I go to this tool on the top. This is a very amazing tool. So over here, if you use this tool, it will reduce the transparency of the object, of the element, of anything in that matter. So now you see the difference between the floor and the background. Now, what else do we need to add? Now we need to add our Wonder Woman, our main character. I again go to my approach. And I will choose a character that I need to add. Now, I cannot make her stand right there. Otherwise, how will Steely Burgers run? So, I will put her inside the window. I zoom my screen. And I will put Wonder Woman, I will place her right in the small window on the door. Then, I will cut her from the bottom till her legs. So it looks like that she's inside the restaurant and she's looking from inside the restaurant to the outside through that glass window. Then we'll zoom out. And now we need to add the burger that she was enjoying. How do I know that what is the favorite dish or the best dish in this cafe? I'll tell you how we'll add that. So let's say the best dish in this cafe is a pizza. I go to my elements, type pizza. I will choose a pizza that is much more tempting. Okay, and let's say that I'm gonna choose this one. I will shrink it according to the size that I want. Place it right on the top of this window, but I don't want to show it that prominent. So what do I do is, I again go to the transparency and I will reduce it. So our pizza is like, you know, it is there, but it's not very prominent than the other characters. So now we need to add our last character in this frame, that is Steely Burgers, our robber. So we go to elements and type robber. So now I see that this is an illustration or element that is good to choose. So I choose that and I place it here on the top, and it looks like that he's running. And right next to him, I put my text box. All right. So now he says that I got so much cash in burgers, ha ha ha. So now in this frame, according to our caption, Wonder Woman is inside the restaurant. She was enjoying her burger. This cafe provides good pizzas. It's a cafe. We have added our thief / robber, and he's running away with the cash where he's laughing. So with this, we are done with our third panel of the story. So I want everyone to clap and show me some thumbs up and, you know, let me know that you're understanding this And if you have any doubts, please type it on the chat section so that someone can reply you. Come on, guys, let's do that. Should we go to another panel? Yes, yes. All right, let's do that. Great, fantastic. So now over here, you can see that there's this caption written, but there's only one caption with two panels. So it is not always necessary that for every panel, you need to have a caption. You can have one caption and then you can have two or three panels according to your story requirement, according to your requirement of the board. So what I've done is I have just added one caption, and within this caption, I'm going to show my visuals right in these two boxes, in these two panels. So let's go with the first line. It says, Steely Burgess tries to escape, but Wonder Woman leashes her whip around his legs and hangs him by his feet from the ceiling and stuffs his mouth with burgers. The police comes and arrests Steely Burgess. The cash is returned to the restaurant and Wonder Woman saves the day. So in the first scene that we have over here, we need to show that firstly, Wonder Woman is running behind Steely Burgess. So how do I do that? So I'm going to show the same scene to, you know, make use of the element. And I will select this cafe, select the pizza, which is here, and select the floor. I will copy it, Control C, and then I paste it. Then I drag my elements to my current frame and adjust it according to the size that I require. So again, I double click them. I get these four corners. I align them properly and just like that. And what do I see? That again, I hit my text box. Silly me. So what do I do again? I send it backward once, twice, thrice. All right. Then I choose this, bring it to front. Send the background to back. So I again got my text up on the front, but it's still behind the pizza. So I'm going to bring it one more time to the front, or send the pizza to one step backward. All right. So now we have a dialogue box ready. We have a scene also ready. We just need Wonder Woman to be there, who is running behind Steely Burgess. I put her right there. So I've always chose my character with a particular with the form that I want them to be. Like over here, she was just relaxing, then she was flying, then she was just standing and looking, and now she's running. So always try to choose the character according to the storyline, and you can always, play with the pictures around. If you don't get one single character like this, you can use multiple characters and change the color to similar form and with, similar elements so that they don't look very different, but at the same time, we understand that you're trying to depict your one character with different actions. So now we are ready with our fourth panel by using the similar elements from here, just with different, with the same character with just different action. Now in our fifth frame, our story after this says that, right after Wonder Woman says that he's getting away, I need to take him down fast. So after this, Wonder Woman actually catches Steely Burgess and ties him to a pole or a ceiling. So how do I depict that? Now in this scene, we are already outside of a place. So I want to show the sky. So I again go to my elements. I choose probably a park or a garden. I type park, hit enter, and I see my options. I'm going to try some other synonym for better illustration. So let's say garden, hit enter. All right, I see a good fence with clouds. I place it again properly, aligned to my panel. Fit it inside that panel to avoid different spaces. But I don't want this, this background. I want a different color for the background. So I shift it aside, choose a background first, and go to the color panel on the top, choose a blue color. So this looks much refreshing, and it looks much, the color scheme looks really nice with green and blue right there. All right. So now, again, we have to bring our text box in front. So I send this to backward, one more step, backward. So now both of my text box are on the top. Now, after this, what I have to do is I have to add my Wonder Woman. So now I have chosen a Wonder Woman where she is, holding a whip, the lasso of truth, and she is ready to catch Steely Burgers. Right. And then I add my robber with a similar, action where Wonder Woman hangs him. So I need somewhere he's standing straight or, he's upside down. So I go to elements again, type robber. Hit enter. And I'm trying to find. And then I see this. So he's standing straight with the bag. So firstly, I try to crop the bag as much as possible. And then I turn him around 180 degrees. How did I turn him around? There's a small button right there. It's a small circle with two arrows. You can, just click it and it will give you an option of, rotating your element. Before that, I need to add either a pole or a ceiling. So I again go to my elements, type a pole. Choose a pole that I need. Place it here. And, I will shift my text box here so that it doesn't overlap. Place the pole here. Place the Steely Burger behind this pole so that I cannot see his leg. And now, as you can see, it looks like that he's upside down to a pole. Wonder Woman hangs him to this pole. But still, we can see a little part of the bag. And if we crop more, we will crop his hands. So I have a trick for you. In such problems, what you have to do is, you have to go to your elements, type rectangle, hit enter, choose a rectangle, shrink it to a smaller size that is required for your bag. Place it right on the top of the bag. And choose the background color. So if your background is white, you choose white. If your background is of some other color, choose that color. So now you see that it has almost hidden your bag. So it doesn't look bad that something is missing, right? Now I'm going to send this one step backward to get my text box on top. I will put my text top here. Send this to one step backward. So all these adjustments you can do by trying. If something comes and overlaps between each other, you can always use these four tools, as I told you, so that you don't overlap and there's no problem of you to edit stuff. So now over here, we have a scene ready where Wonder Woman takes a whip out. She hangs Steely Burgers to the pole and she says, now you cannot run away, Steely Burgers. Police is here to arrest you. And Steely Burger says, I got caught. I am sorry. So with this, we are done with our fifth box, fifth panel. And now we are going to zoom out and see that, you know, what have we done till now. So till now, you must have seen that we have used very basic elements, very cool and nice and appealing colors, and, you know, with proper alignment, with two different characters, two different text box. You can add more panels to it with the caption written on it, choosing a font which is easily readable. And the story started very simply where she was, Wonder Woman was relaxing at her place. Then she wanted to eat a burger. She goes to a cafe where she sees a villain. She runs behind him and catches him. So now we are left with our last part. Our last part here is the moral of the story, the happy ending of the story. How do you sum up with the story? That is what we are going to do here. So over here, she, now after, you know, getting Steely Burgers arrested, where will she go? She will go back to her home, where we have already showed her living room. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to keep this aside. I'm going to copy the first frame entirely, because these are the elements I'll be using for my last frame also. Drag them down. Remove the elements that I don't need. I just select them and delete them. I don't need the background because I already have here. I align everything properly according to the frame that I have. Whether it's my floor, whether it's my sofa, you know, whether it's the window. I don't need this text box because I already have a dialogue here written. I bring the dialogue box to the front and I keep it next to the Wonder Woman. So whenever you add your dialogues or whenever you add any text box, keep it near to the person whom you're talking about. So if there's a dialogue for the robber, I have kept this dialogue box next to the robber, similarly with Wonder Woman. Or always you can use such boxes where it's pointing to the person that you want to go with. Now over here, it says, Wonder Woman says, that a true hero is never off duty. She should always be ready for some action. Kapow. So with this, we have completed our story again with very simple elements. We have just copied and pasted the first frame itself. So a lot of times, you know, the copy paste happens because, you know, sometimes a person doesn't move from one place to another a lot. And your story is more about the ideation and the sort of the message that you want to convey rather than multiple places. But if it's going from one frame to another, so the story changes, you can always add elements to complete your story. So I'm going to zoom out and I'm going to show you that how it looks. All right. So I see that I'm getting some, all right. I'm getting some questions, so I'm going to answer them first. So it says that I have to leave the Zoom call 10:30. So, okay. All right. So don't worry if you're missing this class. If you're missing this class, you are going to get a recording of it. So that while you are working on, you know, the storyboard, and if you don't understand something, you can always look back to this video and you will understand that where is the tool that you want to go with, or what, you know, what things you can use, or how to search for elements. Okay, so don't you worry if you are stuck with the, you know, with something, we are always there with the recording and you can go forward with it. So over here, all right. So over here, I just want to say that, you know, by using very, very, very decent elements, by using very decent colors, by using very different, different but easy characters, you can create your whole storyline. Try to keep equal spacing between one frame to another. Try to keep the font which is readable enough. Try to not overcrowd your frame. Try to keep your story within 6 to 8 boxes. And if you're keeping it less than that also, that is all good. You can always work with 4 to 8 number of boxes. So now here, as you can see that, you know, there are a lot of other things to explore on Canva. Like, for example, that if you want to, you know, change the font, you can change it very easy. You can click on the text box and on the top, you will see options. If you do this drop down, you will see a lot of free options. Again, I'm emphasizing on free. Please use only free fonts and free elements. So over here, you can see multiple, fonts there. You can always choose the font that, suits your story, suits your ideation. And you can always please try to use the readable fonts. Then over here, you can adjust the size of the font. So let's say you want to go with, 7.5, 8.5. You can choose according to your story. You can always adjust that. Then you can always adjust the color of the text, color of the font. So black is always, always good to go. But if you're taking a very darker background, you can go with white and try using colors which are, again, easy to read. You can make the font bold, italics, underlined. You can make it cap. Have a uppercase, lowercase. So in case if you want an uppercase, it will make your every single word, every single alphabet uppercase. So I will keep it to the title case here. And over here, you have different alignments. Left alignment, justified alignment, right alignment, center alignment. We have also a bullet point option where you can click on this and it will add a bullet. But I don't think so that you need to use it in a storyboard, because storyboard process is almost, adding captions, not multiple captions. So you can skip this. Then you have this is one of the important tools. You can add spacing between the letters. So let's say your font is very crowded, like the every alphabet is very close to each other. You can adjust the spacing between every alphabet and the spacing between two lines. You can always adjust to your requirement, whether you, if there's more space, it becomes a very, very catchy and cleaner. Then you have another tool that I have to tell you was the transparency tool, like we did with the pizza, right? That, not making it very prominent, but it is still there. And we have a lock option. So sometimes you have already completed one frame and you're very scared to move anything around and you don't want to spoil it. You always choose that element and lock it. Once you lock that particular element, it won't move. So your alignment won't change. Your composition won't change. So, and every time you have to unlock that, click on the button again and it will unlock itself. So, and over here, we have already seen what a template does. Reminding you, template helps you to get started. You can choose, any template that you like, and you can get started with it, with your specific storyline, with your specific requirement. Again, I've told you about uploads. If you don't find anything here, you can go to Google. You can download the image that you want to be here. Try to keep it in PNG. PNG is without the background. Like I had these characters without the background, you can download them. Then you have elements, which is a very, very, very important tool where you can choose any element, any keyword you use, any synonym that you can use, try that and see multiple illustrations. Choose the illustration that is good for your illustration set. Text, again, text is a tool where you get multiple texts with two fonts combined together. If you have to use something, choose it, ungroup it, and you can use it. Then you have background. Over here, you can choose a different background for your storyboard. I would suggest that you use only white, because when you use white, your other colors come really nicely and they, you know, they create a contrast which comes out very beautifully. If you use a background, it's somewhere, you know, overshadows your story. So don't try doing that. But still, in case if you have something great in mind, you can always go ahead with it. Then I'm just going to show you some illustration sets that are already there on Canva. So let's say that I like one template, but I'm working on another template. I just open the illustration set as a new page, click on that, copy that, and put it to my existing design. Right? Very easy. It makes our work very, very, very easier. Similarly, we have, you know, faces, we have different, you know, pictures, you have different, you know, styles of body, then you have illustration set where you have hearts, you know, the emojis or the mask, which is really trending right now. And then you have, you know, the heart question mark. You must have seen these in those comics where, you know, someone is really pissed and you have this here, exclamation mark, the bulb to get an idea and things like that. So you have multiple options. It's all for you to explore and come up with your own set of things. Again, reminding you, you can add more boxes just by adjusting them. You just have to copy paste it, change the color of the background if required. So my story was now what, 6 pages? Now it's 6 panels. Now it's 8 panels. Don't try to make it that small, because then you know, your character won't be visible properly. Keep this as the standard size. If you want, you can, you know, just shrink it a little bit and add more boxes, but don't make it very small. So children, with this, I think we have almost covered every basic thing that you need to design your own story. I want you to explore this, you know, maybe whenever you get time, you get to a time in the evening, you can do that. Tomorrow, you can do that. And by trying this, you will understand it better and you will learn new things. So I'm really looking forward for you to give good submissions and try this very nicely. I know that you guys have amazing ideas, and like with Miss, our wonderful teacher, Miss Zaira, you have come up with so many good ideations, and I want you to execute it right here. This is a platform for you where you can learn, you can create good things, and you can show people that what innovation and how innovative you guys are, what interesting ideas you are coming with. So I'm looking for good stories, I'm looking for beautiful comics, I'm looking for good color schemes alignment, and I'm looking for the person who wins the first position. So I'm done here, and I wish you guys all the best. So I would like to introduce back Mr. Parth, who's gonna tell you that how we can do this. And one more thing that I want to tell you before, you know, going back, is that how will you download your comic? So over here, as you can see, we have a download button right on the top. Right? So my how will you show it to other people? How will you, you know, share your comics with other people? So the thing that you can do here is you can go to PNG, keep the size same for the artboard, and select the page that you want. So over here, I'm telling you how you have to do that. So when you are putting these comics on your comics wall, or you're putting these comics on your, you know, and sharing it with different people on your social media, so what you have to do is go to the download, go to PNG or JPEG, choose one style. JPEG is the one format where, you know, you have high quality images, and JPEG is this little smaller size because you have to keep your pictures within 5 MB, right? So over here, you can go to PNG, okay, and select the page that you're working on. See, now I have some 14 pages. You don't have to save all 14 pages. You have to just select the page that you want to save. So my page number is 2, where I was working. So I go to download, select my PNG, select the page that I was working on, unselect all the pages, only select page number 2 where I was working here. Click done and download. So over here, you can see your work is getting downloaded, and then you'll get a notification, a pop-up saying, design downloaded. That means it is there in your downloads. And you can see your design has downloaded like at the bottom. So now Mr. Parth will help you that how you can put this design on your comics wall, and you can, you know, you can just share it with as many people as you can. So please, Path, can you take over?
Sure. Yeah. Thank you, Sanskriti. That was really insightful and that was really helpful. Hey kids, hi once again. Welcome back. All right, so we can continue. First of all, yes, once again, thank you, Ms. Sanskriti, for the design session. I am sure the kids thoroughly enjoyed it. Now, moving ahead, kids. So, Ms. Sanskriti taught you how to, you know, submit, how to create your comic strip, okay, and how to save it. Now comes the important part. How do you actually submit your comic strip to us so that it is a part of the competition? And for that, you know, it is kind of a process which for which I would request your parents to be a part of it, so that later on if you need some, you know, help, you can take it from them. So could you please call in your parents for you know, quick 2 minute. Wonderful. So I see Tarun has gone to fetch his parents. Everyone else, could you please get your parents? Wonderful. All right. Okay, let's wait for 30 more seconds for parents to join in. Okay, kids, could you please give me a thumbs up if your parents are nearby you? If they have come, you can just give me a thumbs up and I would understand that. Okay, I got a thumbs up from Srinika. I got a thumbs up from Akshaj. Okay, Shreyansh, Harshika. Wonderful. So yes, parents have joined in. Okay, I guess. Yes, I got a thumbs up from Tarun also. Okay, so yes, hi parents. Once again, welcome. The kids have now understood how to, you know, design, how to create a story, how to design a comic strip. Now comes the part of the competition where you'll have to submit your comic strip to us. So let me reiterate the timeline once again. If you remember, we said that in these master classes, we'd be learning how to design a comic strip. Today is the 6th of June. So you have today, 6th, 7th, and 8th. We would begin accepting the comic strips from 9th of June. And you have until 18th of June to submit your comic strips. So from 9 to 18, you have all these days wherein you can submit your comic. And on 20th of June, we would be announcing the winners. Now comes the part, how do you submit your comic strip? So I'm sharing my screen over here and I'm going to show you an email that you would be receiving that, you know, that you would be receiving on your parents' mail address. So here is the email that you'd be receiving. It says that the time has come. It's time for your child or children to publish their comic strip for all to see. The creativity and talent that have gone into these comics is, are, you know, is astounding, and it will be tough to choose the winners. So you see here, you have an upload option. So in this email that you'd be receiving, your, you know, on your parents' registered email ID, you just have to click on this upload button. Once you do that, okay, it would open this particular page, that is submit your comics. It would open this page, which is submit your comics. And here you would be having the option to submit your comics. You see, there are certain details that you need to fill over here. But before that, I'd like to go through the rules that we have, certain, you know, details that I've shared over here. The first details say, you know, it talks about that kindly enter your full name in the above form. The name in the exact manner would be printed, you know, on the participation certificates that you would be receiving for comics. One more thing that you need to remember is that the comics file, that is the image that you're uploading, should be .png or .jpg, which Ms. Sanskriti just taught you how do you download that, you know, into the image form. Also, make sure that the image is not greater than 5 MBs in size. Okay. Now, let's understand how do you submit a comic. So, as I said, when you click on this particular link, it would take you to this page, that is submit your comics, and you have a tiny form here to fill. You can just enter your details. For example, I am just entering my details. Now, this is not, I'm not the actual entry, right? So let us say I am going with the name Phoenix. Okay. Phoenix Demo 1. Let us say I'm entering my email address as ps. I'm just entering my email address. Okay, I can enter my unique ID over here. Now, this is an important part that you need to remember. You have to make sure that you're selecting the correct grade category. Now, you people belong to the Phoenix category, that is grades 5 and 6. Please make sure you're selecting this so that your image that you're submitting, your comics that you're submitting, would be in competition with the comics that are coming for this category. Once you have done this, you would click on choose file, and you can just open your downloads option. Here I am uploading the Wonder Woman one that Ms. Sanskriti just created right now. Okay. And you simply, hit enter button. You see here, you would be getting a preview of it and you hit the enter button. Okay. Now the comic won't be directly uploaded. If you go through this point over here, it is telling you that check your email and enter the code to confirm your entry. So the email address that you're entering over here, a small verification code, a 6-digit verification code would be sent to you. You just need to enter that code and you click on verify entry. Okay, please give me a thumbs up, guys, if you people are following the procedure. Any doubts over here, anyone? Okay, yes, okay. Wonderful. Now comes the important part. You have submitted your comics. Where do you see, the comics that your friends have submitted, the other people in the competition have submitted. So here itself in the comics details, if you see, the point number 6, all the accepted entries for the competition, would be visible on the comics wall. And if you click here, if you click on this wall, this link over here, it would take you to the comics wall. Now you see, I had posted the Wonder Woman image. It is over here. How do you register a vote for it? You just click on the option. Okay. Here the comic strip would open and you need to click on vote now. Now, once again, you have to, follow a simple process over here. You click on vote now. What would it do? It would send, you'll have to, enter your email address. It would send a verification code there. And once you enter the code, you click on vote now and your vote would be registered. So this is how you can register your vote, but you want more votes, right? You need to share it with your friends and family members. So how do you do that? You see this first option of Facebook. When you click on this, it would actually ask you to log into Facebook, and this particular post would be uploaded on your Facebook page. Please make sure you're using hashtag 90th percentile, hashtag 90th percentile comics. When you're using these hashtags, it would give you a wider reach. It would give you a bigger reach and more people would be able to view your comics. Okay. And finally, if you want to share it with someone on WhatsApp or something, you click on the third option, that is the copy link option. You click on this and the link would be copied and you can paste it anywhere and you can share it with your friends and family members that, hey guys, this is something amazing that I've created. This is a wonderful comic strip that I've created. It would be wonderful. It would be appreciable if you could, just vote for me and, make me the winner for the competition. That is how you can share this with your friends and family members. Okay, so we have learned about how do we submit our comic strip. Any doubts over here, anyone? Please let me know. Okay. If not, then please give me a thumbs up, guys. Okay, wow. So I get a thumbs up from Tharun. Okay, from Srinika. Wonderful. So everyone is following this. Okay, cool. So I guess we are good with this. No doubts over here. Okay. Now, once again, let me just take this ahead. Okay. Now, guys, if your parents are here, hey, parents, this is something for you. Ms. Zaira explained this in the first session, but let me take this opportunity to explain it once again, that we have an event-only offer wherein we are offering 4 weeks of free classes to any of our programs. We offer 4 wonderful programs, that is math, ELA, coding, and public speaking. You can choose, for any of these programs for free classes. It's a very simple procedure. All you need to do is, I'm going to show you the procedure. All you need to go is you just go into the web browser and you can type 98thpercentile.com. Okay. And here on top, you see, you will have an option of free trial. You can just click on the free trial option on top and you would be shown, you know, these four classes, the four courses that we offer. We offer math, ELA, coding, and public speaking. You can select your convenient time zone, and you can see the batches that are available at that particular moment. So you need to select a program, and you see all these batches are available. So, parents, if you feel that, you know, this is something that would be, trust me, it would be really helpful. You can opt for any of these programs, and I'm sure the kids would thoroughly enjoy it. Now, the offer also states that first of all, this offer is valid only till the 7th of June. And second, if you know how amazing our classes already are and you directly choose to enroll, not going the free trial way, if you directly choose to enroll, you'd be getting a discount up to $100 off. Isn't that amazing, guys? Wonderful. Okay, now, kids, this is something for you people. The screen reads, the bee is buzzing again. Can anyone tell me what does this mean? Anyone, you can raise your hands if you feel what is happening over here. The bee is buzzing again. Anyone would like to answer this? Dashita, Tarun, Ishita, Gurleen, Akshaj, anyone? I'll give you a small hint. If you people might, you know, were following our events since last year. Yes, Gurleen, you are correct. Wonderful. You are correct. If you guys were following our, you know, events since last year, you might have realized that in the month of October, we did a wonderful event called Spell Kahoot. And we are coming back with its second version, that is Spell Kahoot 2.0. It is later on in this month. Please ask your parents to, you know, check their email addresses next week, early next week, and they would be getting a link to register that. This time Spell Kahoot is going to be, you know, much more bigger, better, and grander than the one that we had in October. And trust me, you guys are going to have a lot of fun. And that's it from my end. It was a wonderful session. I am super excited, super happy for having you kids over here. And yeah, I mean, I look forward to all the wonderful, you know, comics that you people are going to create, and the stories are already exciting. I am looking forward to the, you know, amazing comic strips, and I'm sure, may the best person win. Until then, that's all from my end. Thank you everyone for joining. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye everyone. Have a wonderful week ahead. Bye-bye. Take care. Bye-bye. Please stay safe. Take care. See ya.